SkyMet is pegging the chances of a below-normal monsoon at 55%, and it has also ruled out the possibility of an above-normal rainfall. Manisha Gupta is joining us with the details. Manisha, this does not augur well for India, clearly.
It definitely does not, yes. 93% of an LPA, which is a below-normal monsoon. But then remember, it's also an El Nino year, where there is a probability of around 66% of a chance of an El Nino in the months of May to July. And that is what really has been bothering. If you look at a month-wise detailing from SkyMet that also has come in its first guidance for 2019 monsoon. The concern periods really are June and July. June is looking at a deficiency of around 23% and July is looking at a deficiency of 9%. Now, July is a critical month because this is the richest month as well. 33% of rainfall contribution for this season comes in from July. And what you lose in July cannot be made up in the months like August and September, which actually are seen as better months. Also, if you look at the last few years, it really hasn't been going very great for India. We did see 2014 and 15 as drought years. 2016 was just about normal, and 2017 and 2018 were deficient years yet again. And 2019 now is an El Nino year. So there is a possibility that we are going to be looking at delayed and a deficient monsoon. And the geographies is of much interest here, because remember, last year there were 8 states which had declared deficient or drought in their regions. And this time around as well, it's pretty much the same states, whether it's Maharashtra, Vidarbha, Marathwada, Northern Karnataka, Western UP, Bihar, Jharkhand. These are the states which actually had seen lesser monsoons in the last year. And these are the states which SkyMet feels could actually be hit harder in this monsoon season as well. But then again, this is early days. And we will see SkyMet and IMD as well come out with more information, updated information as we go ahead. Let's also listen into what Jatin Singh, the MD of SkyMet, had to say on the detailing of this first forecast.
June is minus 23%. July, we're looking at a minus 9. Now, these are significant deficiencies. June is not that important statistically. It is 17% of the total monsoon. But a significant deficit in July is worrying, because July is our richest month when it comes to the monsoon. It is 33% of the total monsoon stack. And in that, if you take away 9%, it's very difficult for it to catch up. So, you know, we need to worry. Also, you know, this is something that we as a country need to make up our minds about. I think below normal is quickly now turning into the new normal, if I might use that American terminology. The last good monsoon was way back in 2013, it was 106. So we really, as a country, need to, you know, huddle and think about what our energy and water strategies and food security strategies are going to be going into the next decade.
Jatin, also come in on the geographies of this, because as you mentioned, even if I take the example from last year, we saw at least 8 states declaring deficient or drought in the monsoon season. Are these geographies yet again at risk, with especially an El Nino forming?
Maharashtra is again at risk. Okay. Marathwada, Vidarbha needs to worry. North Karnataka, you know, again, I think there is a risk. There's also risk in southwest or western MP. Okay, so these have suffered, and now they seem to be perennially suffering in below normal situations where there could be a significant problem there.
All right, Manisha, thanks very much for joining in with that conversation and that story. But with that, it's a wrap on this edition of After the Bell. Do stay tuned to CNBC TV 18. Markets Today Talkback will be up next.